TSM if they go with the standard three on red side, because they pinched the jungle earlier, and I think this Ryze ban definitely warranted. But now I think that you get a first pick Kha'Zix or something like that.
For Rainover, always enjoys playing that one. Malzahar gets taken out. TSM coming off a big confidence boost in game one, looking somewhat like their normal selves in being able to execute, make things happen. The game's still very bloody compared to last splits or any splits, as we get upwards of 30 kills here. Zyra and Camille, there's the LeBlanc, Camille Rengar.
And so you expect a Kha'Zix first pick here with the two supports being banned away. Like the bans from Team Liquid, I feel like these six bans and then that first pick right there is pretty much what you would expect after a game like that. So now you have Rainover in a jungle matchup that should be favorable for him, unless there's something we don't know.
Please. So this is now left up. As it was banned last time, so they're going to pick that first rotation for TSM. Bjergsen gets his Syndra in the blind.
Yep, and the Lee Sin for Svenskeren. It's one that he absolutely loves and performs quite well on on a very consistent basis, but...
And you know Lorlo's going to take Kha'Zix.
Lorlo?
for Rainover.
Yeah. But the matchup, though...
yeah, top Kha'Zix.
...is Kha'Zix favored. I mean, I saw Cali Trolls in the audience. Maybe he's bringing Kha'Zix back. Oh, no, but still. The Echo, I would assume, into the Syndra. It's either Echo or Fizz as the counters to Syndra right now. Mm-hmm. So Echo being locked in. Once again, Golden Blue, favorable lane matchup for himself up against the Syndra here. Favorable jungle matchup in favor of Team Liquid. So they've set themselves up for success. Ooh. They have the Ashe now. Ooh. Didn't want to take the Jhin because they didn't have something like a Malzahar or Zyra to really support it with in terms of a ton of damage to come through when somebody CC'd. But this so far is really good for Team Liquid right off the bat. They have two really good picks for themselves into what the enemy has. And then they have that S tier AD carry.
See if Piglet's on point this time. He did go with the Varus last game, and that will be the choice of Wild Turtle as they swap bot lane champions. So 1, 2, 3 for each. What will the ban here be for TSM? Looking as if with that mid, I'll focus a few more.
See if carry top laners get banned out again, or if they decide to pinch that pool a little bit harder in the support role. But I think you just kind of go back and forth on these top laners. Things like Jace, make sure they can't last pick that on TSM side.
Feels weird knowing this Haunter can go back to that Poppy so easily.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's true. I assume Karma comes through possibly as well as another ban. But they may actually just... What happens here if you ban out the Nautilus? They ban the Poppy, or you first pick the Poppy, they have to play Jace into it? You can really actually just destroy that top lane tank pool. Don't know if it's optimal, though.
Side note, interesting as well, the Olaf goes through on this one. It was banned last time, but then again, you have the Rengar, Camille LeBlanc, TSM would have to ban. Still have the Kha'Zix for Rainover. That ban becomes a Jace on the side of TSM as we get back to phase two. And a final one here for Team Liquid, Nautilus, Poppy.
Yeah, if you ban one, they pick the other. Exactly. And you probably have to pick Trundle, or you pick one of them and then they last pick Trundle. Maybe Karma here as the support. Exactly. So now there's two tank top laners up, so you can just trade them.
Yep.
They will take Nautilus. You can take Maokai for yourself if you want. Or you can counterpick it with a Trundle. But his support pool running a little thin there. You'll have to see things like Thresh possibly for Matt.
I know you can't see it from that angle, but Maokai.
Did I say Maokai? I meant a Poppy.
It's fine. Everyone knew what you meant.
Thank you. It's one of those things where you don't realize that that's what you said, but you meant it the other way.
So there's the Poppy, actually. Okay. Ooh, and the Thresh locked in. Let's put a smile on the face there. Firefrost now. What will you lock in?
Yeah, you had the champion pool pinched so much that you have to go down a little bit, but this is, once again, a comfort pick for Matt. The Thresh is something that Biofrost is also played. So maybe something like a Morgana comes through. Or a little bit more saving potential or stopping the Thresh. Or they go for Nami and just have a fun lane. Ooh. Oh, the Lulu. Okay. Ooh. Lulu's actually pretty good into... the Kha'Zix as well as the Echo. You can stop the Echo from snapping back using the Chrono Break.
All right. Luluvera, Syndra, Lee, Nautilus coming in for TSM. Team Liquid getting a pretty nice composition for themselves here. The Ashe threshing that bot lane. Golden Glue's going to break out the Echo. Not too much of a stranger to that champion. Rainover gets his Kha'Zix once again. We'll keep an eye on the jungle matchup now that Svensgeren actually off that Rengar gets his Lee Sin anyways. And we have a rematch in the top lane with the champion switch. Nautilus now versus Lorlos, Poppy.
And just looking at it overall, bottom lane, a little bit favored for TSM because they have the Lulu and a little bit more harass. But the mid lane goes in favor of TL. The jungle goes in favor of TL in terms of what you know of these matchups. And that top lane, Nautilus has a little bit more shove potential early,
yeah.
But ultimately they're both tanks in the top lane.
Let's see if it may become a problem here for Team Liquid. Not a whole lot of crowd control on that team. You have the Ash Arrow. That's one of the best initiations you can have. But other than that, you're pretty much slowing this team that is going to be locking you down, knocking you up, and maybe even take you out before you hit the ground.
Yeah, and I think the big thing that you're going to be looking for here is how does Team Liquid actually approach the 1-3-1? Because mm-hmm. when you have Echo in your composition, it becomes a 1-3-1 wanting to flank type composition.
Right.
You want Echo to just run straight into the back line and come from an angle that's not the same as the rest of your team, because then you force the Syndra to choose.
Yep.
Where am I scatter the weaking? Am I using it on the Echo,
yeah.
or am I using it on the main force of the enemy team?
Liquid versus TSM as we head on to the Rift now for game two. Team Liquid looking to keep this series alive as TSM came out with a pretty good win in game one. Now that we're on to the Rift, we see how the action will pan out. A lot of the champions have been switched in terms of bot, changing up the Ashe and the Varus for each other. And that top lane has switched the Poppy and the Nautilus.
Yep, Lorlo with Grasp of the Undying as opposed to Cur to the Colossus.
Yeah.
Of course, the Poppy shield still counts as a melee attack for full value on that ability as opposed to a ranged attack. She gets not cut in half, whereas Hauntzer looks like he's got the Courage of the Colossus going for himself.
Just some love taps. Nothing big for the top laners. Thunderlords all around.
Yeah, Thunderlords for the Lulu for the harass.
Mm-hmm.
Some Lulus, you know, they'll go for the wind speakers and the shielding and all that. But this is more harassment-based, just trying to get off damage in the laning phase.
Minions have spawned.
I like it.
Do you?
I do. And we're probably going to be seeing more of Lulu as she got buffed in 7.2.
I just do enjoy Lulu, especially when she came out. It's kind of like a Janna with a bit more speed, offers polymorphs kind of thing. The alts are quite different, but very much similar.
Yeah.
Janna was always big, so seeing her come back, that'll be really fun.
Assassin's Hater.
Yep.
Bjergsen with that early ward on that left side. Walks over there, but they had warded it to see the spot where Bjergsen is, so gives the shove advantage to Golden Glue early. Does miss out on a creep there. But make sure he gets full value there. Actually gets a little bit of harass onto Bjergsen while simultaneously clearing the wave and pushing him back. And this will allow him to ward, or at least... Oh, he actually doesn't ward the Raptors. But he may make them think that he did.
Yeah, just a feint to the top side, I guess. We've been seeing it a bit more. As
bio.
Very, very important in the early game to know where that vision is. So maybe a bottom side gank here coming in.
They're fighting for who gets level 2 first.
One. Swing faster. Auto attack my minions for me.
Matt wants to play up. Play aggressive. And he used to be Matt Life right after his hero. The Thresh god from Korea.
Yep.
Mad Light.
So he did decide to throw out the hook even for harass. Quick phase dive forward to proc his Thunderlords, and they come out just about even. Bjergsen with the heal, though, on that potion.
You can heal, you can trade very heavily because you have the Corrupting Potion as opposed to Adorin's,
mm-hmm.
and you also have Teleport. So it's not bad on the Echo to actually go in for trades like that and lose them slightly just because you have a little bit more regen.
Bjergsen has found a bit of a CS lead in this lane, only making it a little bit harder because Golden Glue can't approach these minions.
Yeah, there's just too many of them. And he threw out his Q,
yeah.
and he's actually going to miss a lot here. He's actually missed a ton of CS. So that wave manipulation by Bjergsen, the way it was bouncing back, and he slow pushed it instead of fast pushed it, gave him level 3 first, gave him the advantage in terms of pushing, so you can't counter or trade, because then you take aggro. And Golden Glue missed out on about 5 CS there that he picked up. A cannon minion included. I saw that one with my own two eyes.
Source?
Yes, now he has to fast shove. Bjergsen gets to walk back to lane. I don't know if he'll actually miss any of these CS because the wave clear is not very good just yet.
Slow going.
This is one.
Easy autos. 1, 2. Just throw those in to make sure. Actually keeps the minions out here, so he's going to try to hold that up very nicely. Pile up more.
Yeah, makes it
and
shove
give Golden Glue even harder time.
Exactly, makes it shove towards him. Mm-hmm. Golden Glue doesn't even back, so he's down 2 Doran's rings in combat stats. This is going to be rough. He's going to need jungle attention to at least shove this out. Yeah.
Cool. Golden Glue steps up. He says, all right, let's just get this pushed.
Yeah.
He's taking his HP for it, though. He knows the situation. He's just getting it done.
Yeah. He's calling Rain over and saying, you know, we got to play to this side of the map. Bjergsen, look at that. He's just going to pull those minions into the side bush. He is being mean. He's being really mean. He's saying, you can't recall. These aren't going to hit my turret.
Great manipulation. Bot side being covered by Svenskeren. No choice to go in as the team gets backed up. Piglet and Matt are now under their turret as Bjergsen is just being relentless. Golden Glue is even trying to play it horizontal.
Yep.
When you kind of feel like you have a disadvantage, you can enter the brush, but Bjergsen is still reaching him with the range.
And the time that Golden Glue is like, I got a recall, Bjergsen recognizes, you got a recall, and he fast pushes it.
Crashes him into the turret. It looks like they all make it too. Lane perfectly resets on that. What play so far here?
Okay.
Still, Golden Glue had trouble last game in the lane, came out pretty well and was still putting up the numbers, so keep an eye on him, and it's not over yet.
Yep. That was a shield interrupting it. Because you take damage on the shield and not your actual HP bar, it does not interrupt your recall.
Yes. No remake.
Nope. Did somebody call for a remake? No. That's how it works. But 10 CS advantage already, like, that was kind of a masterclass in how to manipulate the wave and make sure that you're playing to the side that your jungler is on. Because Svenskeren was on that bottom side the whole time, so Bjergsen knew that he could pull it off into that side of the lane and be completely safe. So he's just absolutely abusing Golden Glue in this matchup. Speaking of abusing,
it's going to be a you don't have a choice, Lorlo play. We'll see. Lorlo, he actually stepped back behind the turret saying, this feels weird. Resident Evil coming in, Blast Cone over. Woo! 1, 2, 3. Steadfast Presence does not block the objects or projectiles, and Bjergsen comes up with that kill. Good safety onto Bjergsen. Svenskeren was able to pick up the assist.
Yep, the lanes of TSM are actually just dominating right now. The top already 10 CS up by himself. No real attention to that top lane just yet. And that was the matchup that I was talking about last game where the Nautilus just shoves the Poppy in. And this is how you take advantage of that. These are the types of plays that you should be looking for if you're on the team that has the Nautilus early, because you can actually just destroy the Poppy like that. He hit level 6 first because he shoved in, and that was the wave too. That was brilliant timing from TSM to rotate at that exact moment.
It's actually kind of incredible to see things happen at that this level of play. You're seeing it take so long just to walk to the top lane that you think that communication would still be there. But they're setting these things ahead. We kind of heard Bjergsen say in their social media video, is it like, when we do things, we need to be thinking of what's actually next. Are we going to push that lane? Do you want to stall that lane? And that was kind of one of those, right? I'm coming back. We have time to go top, and they won't even be able to call it.
Yeah, it's kind of like a... what do you do next? It's like, oh, I'm beating mid lane up. I got 10 CS over him. He's got a bad back timing. Sure, you said what's happening. It's like, but what are they going to do with that? What is he going to do with that? Svenskeren, though, caught out a little bit here. May actually go down. There's 3 on him.
Quick kick. He throws a resonating strike on just to get a bit more damage. Maybe Bjergsen can finish off a kill, but he goes down for his troubles. He did try to get himself inside the jungle, and Liquid bites back.
Here comes a monster. He actually looked like he was walking down there. Here's the lantern. They're being aggressive.
Over. Play back. Got the slow. They're going to put in the autos now. Biofrost should be able to make it out alive, but they do get his flash. So they come out positive on that.
Yeah, and now they get to take control of this right side blue buff. Not going to go over to Bjergsen here. And now Liquid make a play and get this objective.
Very nicely done. Golden Glue not going to have an incredibly easy time in lane still, even with those buffs. Bjergsen's still going to put the damage down, but he has more options now if Drainover can get into that lane.
Yeah, it'll help him out a bunch. And they were able to pull that off, not just off of the fact that they got Biofrost chunked down and got his flash, but because they had killed Svenskeren on the opposite side of the map. So that's what you can kind of do with these plays, is run all the way across the map after they contested your blue, as long as you're really efficient with it and you set your bottom lane up and say, shove to their turret, make sure that you can actually go and invade the jungle, check it out, and then they're able to do that and deny a blue buff from Bjergsen.
That lane as well, down in bot, we saw a little bit of pressure going on to TSM, while Turtle and Biofrost, 74 to 61 in that lane as well. So Piglet having a pretty good game to offer initiation and some damage here.
Yeah, and you do have to be careful now if you're Biofrost, without that flash, up against the flash play from Matt and the possibility of getting locked up with an arrow afterwards. Yep. Biofrost does have to be very careful. This lane is already slowly in TL's favor, where they have about 10 CS up, and they'll catch this wave right afterwards and continue to shove up.
Make sure it's ever so slow building this up. They knew that Matt wasn't here right now. They would be going in, but no forward wards. They see him here on the re-entry, but aren't going to try anything. So things are calm in the bot lane, waiting for six on Biofrost, and Matt may be the cause of it as they start to ward up this next Ocean Drake, making sure it doesn't go to the wayside. Pretty big relief and pressure from just the early part. A lot less kills coming into this game here.
It's good vision control there from TSM on the bottom side of the map. Not having that flash up on Biofrost really would be a lane kill that gets him. Golden Glue. See, this is it. Again, too much control on this bottom side for TSM. You have to kind of force your way in with your jungler to actually take it back with all of these control wards here. Rainover was killing one simultaneously, or at least killing a ward off, and that's why he had to back off.
Yeah.
But now Liquid are actually just getting control of this area.
I like it. Really is going to be a battle of mid laners now. It is CS in favor of Bjergsen, but those kills are there. They've been able to back, probably finish four items about the same time.
Yeah, it's about 400 gold up for Bjergsen at the moment.
Not even that much. Well, considering it's single, it's a good amount.
Yeah, but you do have to take into account that there's a lot of burst now for Golden Glue because he has the revolver for himself, which now just went on cooldown. He can just keep trading into Bjergsen every few minion waves. And slowly chunk him out.
Both teams have knowledge of each other's jungle. Looks like Matt's going to give a little bit of help out here to start this one.
Yep.
For the blind hook, you got to try. Why not? Bjergsen is back. That was pinged just now. We'll see if Liquid is in the area to act anything, though.
Yeah. Goes back, gets himself sword shoes. Close to Morello. Matt does not actually see Svensgeren there.
Very cautious this game from both teams. Svensgeren and Rainover were at each other's neck practically last game, finding each other's pathing, trying to reroute each other.
This at time, each other's neck.
All quiet. Oh, another one over the wall. Bingo.
Got him.
Oops. Oh,
whew. Smooth.
Why, Riot? Why the delay on the box? No damage from him. Gets the ult out of Matt, but he's still hitting the hooks. One of these is going to count with the rest of the team there, and TSM has to be careful. Their roams are getting caught out quite a bit.
And that's the risk that you take when you're exerting pressure, or at least trying to get pressure back and get the vision control in the enemy jungle. You have to take risks. And that's why, just like from a basic standpoint, most junglers are ones that can leap over walls, unique gank routes, but also when they invade, they have ways out. So Svensgeren, it's not really that risky that he's that far forward because he's able to escape. So they're trying to get this vision down. And like you said, those hooks, one day, they might count. But right now, it's just mild inconvenience. You can't go that far into the jungle because they know where you are.
Well, it's supposed to be somewhere within this time we kind of see TSM catapulting that 15 to 20 minutes. Looks like Golden Glue, though.
Yeah, this is that matchup.
Oh,
got the flash.
Oh, Svensgeren's there as well. Parallel convergence does not cause them to go in. More just zoning out the rest of the fight. Bjergsen's flash is down, though, and that was just a rain over all.
Ooh.
One more, and over the wall, Svensgeren is choosing the correct direction each time. A control ward helped him out on that, but he's getting out of these sticky situations.
Yep, that was actually the flash from Rainover, as well as the flash from Bjergsen and Svensgeren, and now TL are doing what TSM used to do. Contest those blue buffs, get them every single time, chunk out the jungler when you have an advantage, and they have the better matchup in mid and jungle, so they should have priority in both of those lanes. As you saw, Bjergsen got chunked out, had to back.
Oh, Golden Glue, after being kind of hit back, pushed down in CS in the lane, goes at Bjergsen very hard, close to his turret, knowing it would give them that dragon priority. Also, timing as well. TSM getting the turret in the top lane, so a bit of a trade there.
Yeah, it was just that damage that had been dealt to it slowly but surely over time, and that gank that came out on the top lane when Lorla was level 5 and Haunter had just hit 6. Ends up with that turret. It's kind of the cascading effect. Slow push. But the fact that Nautilus just has more wave clear early than the Poppy means a lot and just ends up being like 100 damage every wave. Just
Haunter
a little bit.
And Bjergsen are the same practically over their lanes. 140 to 14, 140 to 118. So the solo lanes for TSM farming very well throughout these games.
And firing at the blue buff exit.
I feel it.
That's a long stun too, so might have to catch him.
Haunter phoning home. He's saying, I need some help, guys. I can't move for a while. This is the crowd control now coming in from the TL team. Hook misses, but they're just going for the predicted flash on Haunter. There's TSM on the other side of the map. They're getting vision. They're using this time accordingly as they know they're losing their top laner.
That's the worst feeling as well. Piglet didn't even get an assist. That's like his setup arrow. He doesn't even get an assist on that kill. That's messed up, man.
I feel that.
Yeah, when you hit a tank, they just live way too long and you just don't get credit. But that was really well planned. Instead of shooting it straight at the blue buff, he knew the blue buff exit is the where you want to shoot.
Right.
Sentences are hard.
Lead them.
Yep. Now, four men coming to the bottom lane here. They have priority over Golden Blue, who may have to teleport in here or Lorlo.
Oh,
that's
wow.
Golden.
TP's in. Matt hits the hook, kind of shuts down Turtle's damage for a second, but he's out of that instantly. Delivers the death sentence back.
Went back to mid.
The belt forward as Chrono breaks all the way back to the mid lane, trying to get pressure on the turret now.
Which I actually think is right. If you actually go
back
to
fight,
mid.
Yeah, that fight was pretty much over.
Yep. He got the exhaust too out of Biofrost. So the flash exhaust out of Biofrost. Now he gets to just smack away at this turret, deal a decent amount of damage, and see what Bjergsen does, because he doesn't have the ultimate anymore. He doesn't have the flash. If Golden Glue could get a chunk here, and yeah, even with Golden Glue not there, they will get the bottom turret here, even up that turret count.
On mid, actually looks...
That's below half.
Below half, and Golden Glue's been holding his pretty well. It's mainly been pushed towards Bjergsen once Golden Glue got some levels in that queue. He's kept it up, and the thought to do this as well, deter the turret dive, and head back home.
Yeah, that was a little bit mixed there in terms of how I feel about that, because while Turtle got hooked, he had turret aggro from his ultimate, then he walked away and got hooked. So the turret aggro actually swapped to Svenskeren. It got them to kill on Svenskeren, but it may have been able to get them a kill on Wild Turtle if the turret had stayed on him, or at least get a heal or a flash afterwards. But I think it actually worked out for the best because it went on a guy who didn't have flash.
True. Svenskeren now 0-2 and 2, having a bit more difficult of a game.
Yeah, in this game, once Golden Glue gets going, gets a Lich Bane, gets an Abyssal, it's so hard to take him out. I don't know who you really throw against him. Bjergsen can't really 1v1 the Echo, and just comes to gigantic split push threat, and that's why people are loving this champion as a Cinder counter. Because Cinder wants to pick people, wants to catch him. Echo just wants to split push and 1v1, and he's quite good at that.
Haunter says, all right, calm down. Svenskeren comes up to help. Actually, it's going to be a party here from Team Liquid as they start sending four up. An assist ping on the mid turret. Bjergsen still feels there's going to be some pressure there, and he's right. Piglet is approaching that mid wave.
Yeah, I was like, if Piglet just plays a little bit too far forward, sometimes they do this. They leave the Piggy out a little bit too long. He just gets caught. He wants that minion wave. He wants that farm. If he's up against a Syndra, it's like, that's not what you want. You want the Echo, or at least the Poppy there.
Yeah. But sometimes it's just that one more CS.
And yeah.
You just need the one more.
Every time you tell yourself one more, you're like, this is risky, one more. You get caught. But didn't get caught there. Backed off, so showing a little bit of restraint. Also didn't know where a lot of the members were on TSM. And now they have to try and wave clear this mid.
Would be a
Here's
perfect
a flank.
Time to have a flank come in. I was going to say, where are the forward wards? Orlo. No more crowd control from the Thresh. That's a burn down on Svenskeren. One for one.
Orlo.
As they continue the fight. There's Lorlo coming into the fight. He's able to hit up on Bjergsen. They follow along with Biofrost as he tries to assist his mid laner. And that is a triple for Rainover now. 4-0-1 here in game two.
Comfortable jungle matchup for Rainover. One that he has an advantage in. And then they gave a favorable mid lane matchup here. And Golden Glue with the flank here. Taking care of business, man.
I was about to say, where's the flank coming in from Lorlo? Not that he hasn't, but With TSM pushed up, a few forward wards from Team Liquid. They were just able to take the face-to-face fight, though. And something we don't see all too often anymore. The Rift Herald being taken here by Liquid.
Rift Herald, I assume they give it to Golden Glue as well.
It's been a lonely Herald.
So you can be split and pushing and trying to 1v1 for most of the game.
Feels good.
So yeah, it's actually calling this type of composition the mullet composition. Because you always have just business in the front, trying to just fight each other's tank line, stuff like that. And it's a party in the back when the Echo shows up and just disrupts everything. And then the side flank too from Orlo. Really, really well played to actually just flash in, be right there on time. Hanser was pushing a side wave and didn't decide to TP in.
Yep.
He did. It's definitely too late.
You can see in that replay, those were currently placed wards for TSM. The timer had just started and there were multiple already placed wards for Liquid. It gave him the upper hand immediately.
And that's the collapse of a 1-3-1 as well, where you have the pincer maneuver. So everybody just kind of gets herded away from the Echo and towards where the Poppy is, who then just slams somebody into a wall.
Now with a chance to be back out on the Rift, you can see TSM is throwing down a litter of wards.
Yeah, trying to get control of that Cloud Drake, whereas mid lane, a little bit below half. And now, Haunter's actually getting chased off. Svensgeren was looking for a flank.
Gets himself out safe.
Yeah, there's a timer right now for like Haunter. As a tank, you get to shove out the top wave, and then you get to chill in this area in between until it hits your turret top lane, and then you take top lane damage. But now the Echo is on the top side, stopping the return of the Nautilus. So now TSM have to try and make a play to stop that top turret from going down.
Ooh, Death Charge onto Rainover. Nice ultimate out of Haunter.
That's probably gonna be
easily over the wall. Yeah. And then they kind of waste Haunter's time a little bit. Yeah, Lorla won't have the range to get that down as the minion wave creeps away ever so slowly.
But now you go up there with a numbers advantage when you know that the Syndra's backing on the right side of mid.
Ward check as well.
Try to pick it up. The Echo's in there.
They've been very hesitant on this top side. Obviously, it's hard to get through a Nautilus. Svensgeren is kind of just safeguarding and hopping his way through the jungle, which has been able to keep this one alive. But Liquid would love to get this gold and finally break open the map so they can actually start moving through the jungle, just like TSM is, to defend it right through the middle.
I actually overestimated how much, or underestimated how much health was on that turret up top. They have these turrets rather low, both mid and top. And this one's actually about half. So it's almost all of those outers down. Then we get to the fun vision control part of the game where picks happen and people make a lot of mistakes.
I'm ready for picks on this one. We always see with the Syndra composition from TSM, they take place in a brush, quick scatter, and then you are deleted. That's their kind of Baron play once they get to it. It's probably going to be behind that red if they repeat history as well with how they do it. And right now, towards the mid lane, looks like they're going to put pressure down in the mid. Haunter's still floating around on the top side now, but he's going to be able to clear wards and say, nobody from this side. Let's try to do it.
Yep. They have a superior wave clear. Golden Glue's going to try to go for another flank or at least a collapse of a 1-3-1. But no, he says that they back off mid, so they didn't siege as much as TL had hoped. That's the thing. Sometimes those sieges are baits, where if they siege long enough and try to get that mid turret, it actually just gave time for the collapse. So TL kind of looked like, all right, we have to give up this turret, but it actually ends up being a fight that gets turned around. And TSM sniff it out and says, we only get about 5 seconds on this turret, and then we have to back.
Definitely got to be something out of the box here. They are just kind of walking at each other, expecting a mistake to happen. The flanks were really what TSM was able to use last time. It looks like this is just brute forced out here, though, in mid.
Yeah, because of the fact that Echo has priority bottom and in the bottom side jungle, that he gets to go between mid and bot. So now you can't really stand in any position in the mid lane and not expect an Echo to come out of the bush or throw his W in stun. But Haunter has to come down here to clear this wave. So if TSM had stuck around, would it have been maybe a teleport burn from Haunter or a 4-on-3 in favor of TL?
Orlo, top level in the game up here. He's just been farming away.
Yeah, this is what you want to do is just kind of whittle them down because now the Syndra is having to deal with a Poppy, which won't usually result in a kill. It'll result in a lot of orbs being thrown down. That's the 1-3-1, is they want the Syndra to not be part of the fight.
Haunter closing himself in. Doesn't look like he's going to be able to find an anchor toss here. He also walked right around the Pixel Brush, which is holding a control ward for Team Liquid. So they have the bottom side of the map covered. That actually gives them a lot of good vision to say they're in the fog of war, so we at least know where they are without being able to see them. TSM can almost do the same thing. They're getting their wards pushed forward so that same effect happens for them. They're keep warding this left side, blue, and pressure on the turret.
Yeah, Golden Blue needs to back because he can actually make a purchase right now. He's got about 1,200 gold. Gets the Lich Bane for himself, so he'll shred the turrets, but this is where they strike.
Straight in, good hop off
TPs.
By Raid over, but
both TPs
by Haunter as well. Where's Poppy coming in? That's Golden Glue and Lorlo coming in from the backside. Like you said, party in the back, Sirene. Turtles the first one. They go for the Keeper's Verdict. Svenskeren and Biofrost are knocked up, but Biofrost leaps out of the fight with his flash, leaving the rest behind. No Glitter Lances to turn the tide away. They just have to keep running.
Yep, and they're actually just going to shove up the mid lane here and get a little bit of control of this top side where the Baron is. Shove them out with this numbers advantage. And possibly get this tier 2 mid, which is very important.
Just about every flash used for Liquid there, which does become scary. There is still a chance they go deep at one of these turrets, but they're playing it smart. Liquid make it out, and we've been waiting for the TP plays coming from the team.
Blue buff, another blue buff for Golden Blue here. Absolute control of this great jungle and mid matchup here. Can't stress that enough, is that the pick ban definitely favored the jungle and mid here for TL, which is what you need when you're taking down TSM.
This is
the chain got flashed away, so Rainover didn't get hit, doesn't spread to everybody else. Piglet's so far in the back, he just gets poked out. And now Golden Glue and Lorlo, so many abilities were used to peel or engage, and now they don't have enough to actually keep these guys alive. Great W there to stop the safeguard. Svenskeren has to now be a little bit too far forward, and he gets chunked out as well.
Fingers were hitting the right skills. Biofrost had a great wild growth to stop the Poppy hit. Like, things went the way they should for TSM there, but it was just too overwhelming from Team Liquid.
Mullet too strong, man.
The steel mullet. It's coming up on 26 minutes now. We finally get this game broken open just a little bit. 8-4 as the kills start piling in. And only a bit of a gold lead here, so you can see just how much these fights are separating the teams. They're very, very close.
Yep, Infernal coming up. So TSM trying to get some agency over this area and take it down, but
Ooh.
I haven't seen one of these in a while.
I see this screen quite a bit. Your screen just goes gray. You just hang out. So looking at the scoreboard, it seems like much more should be happening for Liquid. 5-0-1 on Rainover, 3-0-4 for Golden Glue, 0-0-6 for Piglet, which always kind of feels bad because an AD carry, you're like, if that was six kills, I would be so rich right now. But still, it doesn't hurt to have those six assists. He's getting his items completed.
Should have had seven.
With that lineup, it just seems like they should almost have more map control, be more offensive, but they seem to be playing a bit timid.
Yeah, and you're speaking of Piglet, having a little bit of a keyboard issue, and that'll get resolved soon.
Right. He's like, I'm not getting kills, I'm only getting assists.
It's definitely the keyboard, I swear. But all jokes aside, the game, like you said, is in favor of TL at the moment by a decent amount. But the way that their composition is crafted, it's a 1-3-1 that is slow during this part. You just need to make sure the Echo is stronger than the Syndra, so the Syndra has to find something else to do on the map. And the Echo just gets to flank, TP in. And so they'll usually play around teleport timers or minion waves and how they've set it up or who they've chunked out. Because if they chunked out somebody on like the top side of the map or like the jungler, then they could make a play for an objective, or they take control of that side of the jungle and take buffs. But it's a slow process here for this team, unless they get a really explosive fight. And we just saw one of those for TL to actually just accelerate and get themselves this lead that we're seeing now.
And what are we looking at for TSM here with this composition? You know, Bjergsen's on his Syndra. There's easily still a potential for him to carry. He's been dominating that mid lane so far. We really haven't seen the Golden Glue Bjergsen matchup. They're getting kills from around the map, so maybe working off of him or even not. What is TSM kind of looking to do to cut back in to Liquid strategy here?
Well, I think you always want to play off of Bjergsen, but the fact that they have that weak jungle mid, and Svenskeren's 1-4 with 3 assists at the moment, he's struggling. Especially since he's about like 2 levels down too. He's trying to make plays, and the engage from this team, since you don't have somebody like a Zyra or Malzahar support, you have the counter in the Lulu, you're looking at Wild Turtle to actually land a chain, you're looking at Svenskeren to get a kickback and put himself at risk, or you're looking at Haunter to get a hook, but you're usually wanting your top laner to flank in a lot of these fights.
All right. Back into the Rift. And we will see the Baron attempt. Looks like they had an itch here during the pause.
Strange Baron attempt, because the Infernal Drake is actually just being killed by Hauntzer.
Longest dragon take ever.
He's got teleport too, so
4,400 HP on Baron. It's taking him about 7 seconds to get here. Teleport won't be quick enough. Coming in is Matt, almost Matt. Taken down. Nobody follows through. Make sure he stays out of range of that Baron burn. He keeps himself alive, but get out. A little bit of a pressure there. Things got hectic.
Yeah, that was.
And we're back in the game.
That was awkward. Where just like, TL aren't going for the safe objective with their lead. Where normally when you have a lead and it's a Baron up and all five members are up for both teams, they don't usually go Baron. It's time to go Baron. It's usually time to go get the Infernal Drake. That's not going to do as much damage to you. Not going to put you in as much of a compromising position with the way that the map is shaped. Because blue side playing to the red side Baron, it's not that great. Whereas like the Infernal Drake, Echo can actually close off choke points with his parallel convergence. Right? If you're playing more on your side of the map and have exits on the back of the Dragon Pit.
They try to go here as they see Golden Glue on the top side. Don't have any range to get to Piglet or Matt. So it's just a wave clear. But knowing he's up there, they can kind of split him, clear these wards, and start placing on that blue side once again. They've been losing quite a bit of their blues, so I'm sure they'd love to get a few back here for Bjergsen.
Oh, absolutely. And that's another thing. Like, Bjergsen is doing well in CS and just picking up side lane farm now. But he doesn't have the teleport, and this might be something that gets exploited later on. But look at that. There's no vision. There's, like, literally no vision here. Like, TL are blind.
This is how it works. That bushwhack from a long scout of the week, and you just follow up. Sven Skaren can get in there, kick the guy back. They give up for now. Oh, no, they don't give up. They're still hanging. Shh, don't say anything.
Yep, gotta look for the pick. Ooh.
Okay, quick jump. So many things you have to be aware of as well. If you're Sven Skaren, he can jump, then take a lander. You may be taking a ride you don't want to take. So as well, he's keeping his himself tempered in the engagements.
Yeah, and I was talking about when all the tier ones go down, we're at that point where people start making a lot of mistakes when they're trying to close out, they're trying to get those tier twos and play the vision game.
Yeah.
Because you get caught, you get picked off. And to answer your question earlier about what TSM need to do, play around Bjergsen, play around the pick,
yeah.
Try to blow somebody up before you actually have the party arrive. There's that last one. Last outer turret. So now, the Vision Wars definitely matter a lot. You have to have enough, if you're TL, to cover whichever side you're really playing to with your Echo. And if you're TSM, you need to make sure that you have dominance of the lane, and you can put your Syndra or your Varus in position to make a pick and help your team out.
Checking at the gold, Golden Glue, and Bjergsen both hitting 11,000 right now. 304-212 in the CS gap.
So
these guys are literally even. They're both sitting about a 1,600 gold in their pocket too, so they have items to go back and get. Bjergsen's almost full. Gonna start selling some.
Void Staff for himself.
Mm-hmm.
I assume the Abyssal Scepter comes out next for Golden Glue when he finishes his back. But that's actually kind of greedy, staying out on the map with 1,800 gold. Something goes wrong. Like, if they choose to fight when Golden Glue has 1,800 gold, that is actually wrong.
It always feels really bad, too, because you think, I could be doing more damage here. This could have been that item. And you are hesitant in the fight, which there is no room for at all. But here's Golden Glue.
They're fighting on the front.
He's on the back, can't get towards Lulu. Biofrost is kind of keeping him at bay. Rainover is quite low, being the one that joins the jump in and kind of do that explosive damage to turn TSM's mine around.
But they're actually sectioning off TSM to the left, so they don't have the inside track on mid. Sven Skaren gets hit up.
It's a hook. Very nice by Matt for the walk-in. Flay back, doesn't put himself in a dangerous situation, and they have TSM on the run. But the more you have a team on the run, they have the chance to turn it around.
Yep.
But it looks like they'll stop the fight overall.
But now they're going to try to go towards the top tier two here. Maybe get some damage onto that with that Lich Bane. And now TSM got to go pick up those minion waves. So Hauntzer down to the bottom side.
2,100 gold.
Yeah, this is...
Golden Glue just loves his pockets full. I think he's going to go back here. He gets himself into the brush and he'll be safe. Says team, hold off. Looks like Matt's going to do the same thing. And we get both teams going back now. See what they can get. More control wards. One of these next fights is really going to open up the game here and maybe be an inhibitor turret.
Ah. So Golden Glue back spends and gets himself a Zonya's Hourglass here. Post the Abyssal Scepter.
Yeah.
which I actually do agree with. I think that the exhaust may come through or the Lulu may polymorph you, and then you have to wait. Zonya's gives you time to throw down a parallel convergence.
Yeah, it's so good with the cooldown of his skills, too, because you usually get one of them back.
Yeah, oh, exactly.
You're in or out.
You'll have your phase dive up again, mm-hmm. and also allows your shadow to just catch up to you so you can ulti in place afterwards. They can't camp your body.
So he's alone in the top once again. Like you said, if strong enough, you're going to have to pull the respect of the other team, and he can go 1v1 right now with just about anybody.
But it's like, who do you send to deal with him? Do you send Bjergsen? Yeah. You can't really send the Syndra by herself.
Well, they do. We'll see how it works.
I mean, you physically can do it. You are capable of doing it, but you really don't have a better answer. I'll say that. Like, you have to, like, send one person who can hold against him and then send another and kind of throw him off every now and then and be like, ah, it's two. But that's how you...
Yeah. He's not easily deterred right now.
Throw off the 1v1 or the 1-3-1 strat.
Haunter on Dragon Duty again. 20 seconds there, so he can solo out another one. He'll have Lore Low to play with, though. That's him and Piglet are on the bot side of the map. Piglet's always staying right in range between two of those people. He's got, obviously, Rain Over with him right now on Matt. And it was just a combination of Rain Over, Lore Low. TSM heading towards the top side. Good vision here by Liquid, so this needs to be cleared out. And they don't see anything on the back. So they're actually sitting between the wards of Team Liquid right now.
Ah, and I was looking at the inventories here. Redemption had already come through for Biofrost, and that went for Locket instead of Redemption. Normally you would think, oh, you're going to go Redemption because it's just such a powerful item. But he actually goes Locket with Ruby Sightstone to reduce the cooldown. But hold on, Golden Glue!
Whoa!
He doesn't make it over!
Last Cone doesn't hit. There's the Zhonya's. Parallel Convergence will fall. Give him a slight shield. Phased up over the wall. It's going to be the ultimate. Unleashed power is not going to be enough. Haunter still in the chase, though. He does get hit up. Gromp was actually giving him a little crap, too, on that. And now they're going to be heading for the Baron. They've been waiting so long for one misstep.
Yep.
To finally find it.
Huge misstep there from Golden Glue as well. It looked like he was just waiting to actually use his flash, didn't use it immediately. That's going to be the Redemption coming down for a little bit more healing, and they're going to try to 45. Oh, they're out of the pit. There's three in.
Oh, that's Rain Over in. Rain Over is going to kill. Baron's going to be doing a lot of damage. What a turnaround. The Keeper's Verdict knocking him out. Last Cone back in. That's the smite from Rain Over. Svensgeren's going to drop. Haunter there swinging away. It's going to be a GA. They're going to have to do it twice. The rest of the team scatters. There's only ways to clear. They're trying to repair what's off the ball right now. As Haunter's the ball, and they put it right down once again for another point. 11-5. What a switch around. Liquid playing off their own error.
That was a crazy call. And Lorlo knocking two members out of the pit.
Yeah.
Absolutely pivotal here. That's what we're looking at again here is he pops the ultimate. He actually gets Sven and Hotzer, the two you want because they are the ones who can disengage.
And it was to red side too.
Yeah.
That was a good windup.
This was, ooh. Right here too, like, Hotzer gets back in the pit. Svensgeren doesn't. So he's freaking out a little bit. Damage going down, 217. The smite came out from Svensgeren at about 1,200, I want to say, brought down a little bit further than that.
The steadfast presence as well, stopping the resonating strike where you thought Svensgeren was going to get his execution.
Yeah.
Missed that smite damage, so Svensgeren was thinking of much different numbers when he went in. Team Liquid's going to be grabbing up the cloud now, a little bit faster on top of their sustain with Ocean, and we will actually see another cloud next as we continue on here. 35 minutes into the game, much less kills. As the teams are trying to get these hits in and then get the objective, not just throw their bodies in for the sake of it. Works out towards the bot lane. Baron helping out Lorlo, who has been obviously apart from the team this game and doing quite well on that bot.
Yeah, and that's the only really good thing here that came out of that for TSM was Golden Glue got killed, but also he doesn't have the Baron buff, so he's not as effective as a split pusher as he would have been if he had been alive for that. But TSM, really, the game just swung completely in TL's favor. They have the split push online. Mm-hmm. They have the advantages. They have these hard to clear out minions, so your wave clear doesn't matter as much. Now, TL are trying to take us to a game three.
Yep, we see Piglet's keyboard's working. 108, that kill comes in for him.
Finally got it.
He's much more happy about this game. And it's like, for now, Turtle's gonna be the one to clear on Lorlo, since he can just do it from range. Lorlo can't really approach the turret too much. Nobody can really approach Golden Glue either. Rain Over just makes it worse for the wear, and Haunter watches that go down now as it's up to the doorstep for TSM.
Yeah, we've been talking a lot about how Golden Glue's going for the split push and all that, but Rain Over really set up a lot of this. This guy is performing incredibly well this game. The fact that they went for that call, the fact that they decided to go for that Baron, he got it. He's three levels up over Svenskeren at the moment. He's just been absolutely destroying him in the jungle in this superior matchup. And that's what this blue side gives TL. If it goes to a game three, TSM get to go back to banning three junglers if they want to and forcing the Rengar trade for the Kha'Zix, which worked out for them pretty well last time.
It's been solid throughout this. The strategy coming in, continuously take Bjergsen's blues, don't allow Svenskeren to get much else on his Lee Sin, for that matter. He can't even at that many levels down go in and initiate safely. He has the Guardian Angel, which may help to bring that confidence back up, but it's going to be once TL's on the doorstep, so a lost fight is going to mean the Nexus. TL stripping TSM of any last vision they have in the jungle here, but could also go a little too far forward. Bjergsen's very powerful and could turn the tide of this fight with a quick ultimate on the right person.
Yeah, and so now Lorlo off on the bottom side, the 1-3-1, the constant split push and the pressure here. You have to allocate people absolutely correctly or else you start losing these turrets. If Hanser's going to stay in that top side, means he's not there to engage these fights that are mid. And that's what you have to do if you're TSM, is try to engage on these three members, kill one or two of them before the rest reinforce, or they back off and you lose a turret for it, and you actually don't get that much out of it.
I mean, it seems so easy, but it is so disciplined to not go too far forward. Be the one of those three in mid, get caught. They're doing it very methodically.
Right. It's the idea of the strategy and the tactics behind it, but it really comes down to the execution of the strategy.
Right.
Are you able to actually catch the person out? Do they outplay you? Well, that sucks. Looks like you lose the turret. Like, those types of things happen, and that's why we talk about like high variance in plays. Right. This is actually from TL, a rather low variance now. They can keep going and pushing, and that's why it's so methodical. They're going step by step because they don't want to take those big risks. But they had to take one at that Baron. Paid off, though.
Paid off very well. The influx of gold. We said, you know, Matt went for the locket, but now he has the redemption, which wasn't there a second ago. So a lot of money even coming in for him and the rest of the team.
I want to talk about that because the locket first was a little unusual for some people because you think the redemption is just so powerful. But by the time your redemption goes off on your AD carry, he's probably dead from Syndra. So the locket is an instantaneous reaction to the Syndra ultimate, which can keep him alive. So that's why Matt ended up going for that item first. Oh, looking for the 1v1, maybe? Oh, he went through it!
Belt! Woo, almost caught him. Bjergsen's able to get himself to safety with the gold! In phase dive, comes up huge. The teleport now being struck here from Golden Glue to start things off for Team Liquid. They have all converged in the bottom lane, so they can't kind of do their split push anymore. So they're regrouping. It looks like it's going to be mid lane without Bjergsen.
Yeah, that's the thing. You send your Syndra off to the side lane, it's like, ah, man, we have to shove this other wave out because we're not a 1-3-1 composition. The 1-3-1 composition just collapses with the TPs, and then he 1v1s him, chases him down, gets a little bit of help there. But now they have pressure to Svenskeren.
Oh, the box hook right on the side. It caught the edge of Svenskeren.
Piglet!
Model. He should be safe. Ooh. He just stands right in the front. They say, all right, Piglet, if you get hit, we'll jump in front of you. They're there to be his meat shield. And now they're going for that inhibitor turret. The inhibitor will fall next. And Bjergsen going down from Golden Glue's TP has just struck a fire under Liquid here.
Yeah, they were able to take a lot more off of that push up. They get the inhibitor. And now the blue buff. The blue buff might be coming up once again. Poor Golden Glue. They're just taking everything on their way out because TSM have not had control of their jungle. There's a 10,000 gold advantage already for TL.
What a swing in the game, as well as just to look at the kind of inconsistencies, to not even get kind of consistent play and being able to do the fundamentals, come out of lane again with winning lanes. But then Team Liquid's just able to play the teleport game, something you didn't think would come out on top of TSM for sure.
Ooh. Golden Glue just gets right out of there. And that's the issue. The 1-3-1, if they collapse like that, the Syndra doesn't have teleport, so she can't answer. And she also doesn't have, or she has to shove out that far. She doesn't have the durability or the tanky stats for escapes to get away, which she's collapsed on. So mistake from Bjergsen there to be that far forward.
Back towards Baron. Vision, obviously, for Team Liquid is TSM has to be very careful going in for these fights. I don't think Golden Glue is going to stop anytime soon, at least one or two more waves. I correct myself, his teleport is down, so he may come back up here for the fight.
Exactly, all teleports are down at the moment. So Golden Glue splitting is actually just a big timer, but it puts him on the other side of this team. Hunter looked for a hook, didn't get him a rain over.
They're trying to get that GA out first, very close to hitting Turtle. He gets himself to safety. Hunter has been eating these turrets. Golden Glue locked up on the outside. He can't follow up the damage. Kono breaks back. Him and Lorlo now again on the backside. Piglet trying to focus damage in as we see Golden Glue on the top. Svenskeren, Turtle, Bjergsen. The damage here on the left side for TSM as they do have enough time to finish. Monster. Matt goes down now and they are trying.
He's got ulti.
Slivers of health all around. Don't even amount to a full health bar for the full team. And they are starting to drop Team Solo mid in this matchup. The fight at Baron going for Liquid as they had vision to start. Svenskeren trying to get Baron's help.
Piglet.
And Piglet is running for the base as the team continues. The ace on TSM.
Yeah, Piglet's like, I had enough of this crap. I am going straight for the Nexus. He's gonna try to end the game and take us to game three.
And it looks like they have all the super minions they need coming in with a line 41 minutes in. And Liquid had to put their foot down to make something happen. Both teams were waiting for mistakes the whole time. TSM found one. It was even a mistake that Liquid grabbed Baron off of when they recouped. Now they're gonna be on the Nexus. Now they're gonna bring us to a game three in this series. Liquid take down TSM.
Gold Blue's like, yeah, that felt good. That felt much better, having an advantageous jungle and mid matchup for yourself. Got bullied a little bit, which is to be expected in the early game. But when he was able to get his split push on, he was able to control his map movements a little bit better. Got caught one time. But I know that that's what Golden Glue is working on, is how often is he actually playing the macro game. And that's why they've had like Golden Glue and Link. It's because they have one player that knows matchups a little bit better with Golden Glue, knows how to CS a little bit better in the laning phase. And then they have Link, who's better at kind of shot calling around the map, right? He's about those teleport plays, playing things like the Echo with teleport, right? But Golden Glue, it seemed pretty clean on that game in terms of once he got out of the laning phase. I got to credit a lot of that to Rainover.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, this guy kind of... Kid doesn't go unspoken in the jungle, right? He's 6-0-8. We were calling out his praises. But to see everybody be able to use that now is really nice, because you can do something for your laner and they're like, great, I feel ahead. But we're seeing them now do that with Rainover's presence, the resources he gives them. Golden Glue says, you know what? I'm going to go bot lane. You guys don't even have to be there. I'm going to fight Bjergsen. And they knew they'd at least get a flash. But those little things, they were saying, we're not waiting anymore. TSM does this, they just get stronger, and we're going to have a tough fight. So good on TL for actually pressing that.
Yeah, they also knew their win condition, right? Just 1-3-1, make sure that we can get good flanks off, use our teleports, and collapse on TSM. And played out well for TL.
And we saw one of those moments go in TL's favor here. 18 minutes in, a 3-for-1 in the mid lane, where TL basically just take the lead and then start rolling with it.
This was that collapse where Parallel Convergence comes down, so they get routed, but they get straight onto Bjergsen there with the catch because Svenskeren tried to engage,
yeah.
And they aren't watching their back. Against the team that has Echo on it, you have to watch your back line. And now Lorlo comes in, and they really had no exit from this fight once Lorlo had decided to come up here. And this is what gave them that first little taste of an advantage where they started to come back into this game. So before that, it was a little bit of getting punished in the lanes. Then they were able to have fights that are on their terms.
Right, and we kind of mentioned, or I did a second ago, that, you know, TSM continues to make these games go longer. 33 minutes in, TSM gets their pick. But what happens when they pick Golden Glue? They actually lose Baron to TL here.
Yeah, this was mostly set up by Lorlo, because he ends up hitting Wunderson back. You have a numbers disadvantage after Golden Glue gets killed here.
Right.
So Golden Glue thinks that the Blast Cone will save his flash, because he has... Oh, he doesn't have flash at this point. Ah, okay, yes. Used it earlier.
And then Depth Charge, boop.
So strange. I had seen it as being up. All right, well, I take that back. Still, used the Blast Cone, tried to escape, and then they turn onto it.
And you see, even at first, yeah. Liquid's farming out the mid lane. They say, wait a minute, actually, we could put a lot of pressure on this.
They decide to go for it. It looks like it was a call that they weren't 100% confident in, but the arrow hits Hauntzer. He can't block it by himself.
And that basically had to happen.
And it puts them both inside of the red pit, too. It's not just right over and the Blast Cone back in, and then they just destroy Wild Turtle in the back line. It was originally a numbers advantage for TSM, 5v4, but then it ends up being a 4v3 in favor of TL, and they get the Baron to boot on top of it. And that really turned their split push completely online and got them those tier twos on the side. And even that middle inhibitor turret.
Liquid nicely moving as a squad throughout this game too. You see the teams in the back kind of pondering, what were the errors? What should we go for? You know, the draft wasn't really anything that completely stood out to us. We did get Golden Glue onto the Echo, and he was able to kind of show that it doesn't matter if that's the champion he's currently playing in solo queue. And that's good to see from him, because he was the guy that was always kind of thought as a, you know, he'll be down 10 CS, he might make a play, but now he's being much more consistent.
Yeah, if he's able to actually contribute to his team in a larger factor than Bjergsen is in control the whole pace of the game. Yeah. That game really revolved around the Echo and the Kha'Zix. So they had that winning jungle mid.
Yeah. And it was still a very dominating lane from Bjergsen.
It was.
And how hard he did in CS. It didn't call in rain over as much as well. They didn't kind of get themselves into a troubled situation. So really good team play all around in this game too. We have a third one to go though. Teams are all tied up, but only one can claim the win, believe it or not. Meet us back here for game three of TSM versus Liquid. But first, we're gonna check out the sights and sounds of last week's NALCS mic check. I've never seen